The layout system in NovaMind is one of the very powerful and unique things about the program. No other mind mapping programs have capabilities even closely resembling what we offer, so I'll just go through it in a bit of detail so that you can get the most out of it. You can alter the layout of the mind map by selecting a topic that you want to lay out the subtopics of and choosing a layout option. Quite often, you'll want to use the radial layout for the first level topics and linear layout for the subtopics, but it's up to you. You can change the layout settings on any topic. This means that you can have the subtopics laid out at any angle, either radial or linear, and change it for each topic if you so desire. NovaMind will automatically keep the mind map in the most compact form possible, only moving topics the minimum amount to avoid them colliding with each other. But if you want to have more room between a topic and its subtopics, you can use the advanced settings and set the children offset, which is the distance from the topic to its subtopics, and also the repel distance between siblings. You set the angle that the subtopics are laid out at using the angle control. If you click on one of the quadrants, it will rotate the axes to be either vertical or horizontal in that direction, but if you want it to be laid out at another angle, just drag it to the angle that you want. Normally, the layout of the descendant topics is automatically the same as what you set for the parent topics, but you can take control of it at any level and change the settings. If you want to revert to getting the inherited setting, just click on the Reset to Default, either in the dialog box or the Layout pop-up menu. Sometimes you will want to visually group topics and push other topics out of the way to give this visual separation. This is normally accomplished by inserting a boundary and adjusting its shape as required. And here's a little trick for you. You can actually insert a boundary by using the Boundary Shape setting on the Format tab. Then you can use the Advanced settings to set the margin. In most cases, the automatic layout of the topics should be everything that you require. But occasionally, you may want to move a topic to a specific location. To do this, just mouse over the topic and you'll see both the graft and move controls. To move the topic to another place, drag it using the move icon with the four arrows on it, and to put it back to its automatically laid out position, use the reset location option. If you want to move all the subtopics of a topic back to their default locations, use the arrange subtopics option. Note that sometimes there may have been offsets applied to other topics in order to keep the ones that you moved where you moved them to. If this happens and you reset the moved topic, it will leave the other ones that had to have the offset applied where they were. In this case, you might want to either reset the other affected topics or just select the parent and use the Arrange Subtopics option. As you build your mind map, you are bound to need to graph topics from one place to another on the mind map. To do this, drag the topic by its graphed handle. If you have multiple topics selected, they will all be grafted in the graft operation. The indicator will show where the topics will be attached when you drop them, so you can easily see what the effect will be. If you're partway through a drag operation and you decide you need to cancel it, just press the Escape key. If you want to create a copy of the topics, you can hold the Control key down while you drag the topics. If you have a topic that you want to become a floating topic, just drag it away from the rest of the mind map, and then you can move it to where you want to position it. If you have a floating topic that you want to become part of the mind map, then use the graft operation to drag it and attach it to the mind map. You can also drag topics from the mind map to the outline view, or vice versa. There's more information about that in the video about the outline view. You should be aware that if you're using the radial layout, there are topics on the left and right of the parent topic, and if you just move a topic, it will still be laid out as if it was on the side that it was attached to. So if you want to swap it to the other side, you'll need to graft it from one side to the other. This gives you a lot of flexibility in the way subtopics are laid out in relation to their parents. If you don't want to see the subtopics, you can collapse them away so that they are hidden. You'll see a small plus icon to show that there are collapsed subtopics. Just click it to expand the subtopics.